Hello, welcome to Fallout 76, and in this video I'll show you the best weapons for the beginning of the game. In the beginning of the game you won't have many weapons and you won't have a lot of ammo for them, so I'll just show you the most efficient weapons that I used and played with. So, the first thing you need is a... oh, these things are loud. If you need a pipe weapon, and the best pipe weapon I found, well, I actually got lucky, because I actually found it, is this one. You need a pipe rifle. If you can make it hardened, even better, but this is the best 0.38 weapon I can get. I could get, to say exactly. And you find a lot of 0.38 ammo in the game, but I wasted it all. I had a scope on it, but I switched it for this one because this is mostly a close range weapon. The second weapon I used and I got was this. A Snubnosed 0.44. Well, this is a special weapon, but no matter. As you can see, it has a lot of damage and it actually has a good fire rate, and the ammo is plenty for it. And it fires pretty fast. Well, not as fast as this one, but again, it's a lot more, does a lot more damage. So that's your handgun. And the third weapon was a shotgun. If you can get your hands on a double barrel shotgun, oh, you'll have so much fun with it. I mean, look at this, it does 80 damage. It's better than a pump shotgun in my opinion, because it does a lot more damage, and look how it fires. Very fast. The loading speed is a problem, but then again, you just kill something. You can kill level 10 super mutants with two taps, one, two, and then just hitting them like this. No, not like this, like this, yeah, like this. So it's pretty powerful. You can also upgrade it a bit and it will be even better. But if you can't find a double barrel shotgun, then you just use a normal pump action shotgun. But you really should use a shotgun no matter what. And my fifth weapon is this one, the hunting rifle. Actually, it's a marksman piercing sniper rifle. So if you can't get a sniper rifle, just get the hunting rifle and upgrade it a bit. So you have... this is your .308 caliber weapon. And as you can see, this is the weapon that you find the most bullets for. I don't know why, that's how the game is. A big caliber weapon, and it does 71 damage, and it also does more damage to armor, because I upgraded it that way. So each time you pick up a weapon and you level up, try to enhance the weapon, to modify it. And to do that, you'll need to scrap a lot of weapons. So if you see a weapon, keep it and scrap it, because it will unlock more things for you to modify on the weaponsmith bench. Because right now I can modify a lot of things on my weapons. And you also need a melee weapon. The melee weapon is not that important, but you should always carry one, because a lot of people like the melee combat. A baseball bat, a sword, a ski sword, or whatever this is called. Okay, a skate blade. Wow, that looks vicious. Target bleed, and this is armor piercing and better damage, and this is for target bleed. So remember what to equip on it. Okay, server shutting down because this is the beta. Plasma weapons. Fusion weapons I don't recommend, because they use a lot of ammo, and ammo is very hard to get. And this is it. Because you'll burn through a lot of ammo, you need at least 4 weapon types with 4 different calibers. And let's see what else I have in my ammo box. So, 300.308 is the most common ammunition type. 0.45 is also one of the most common ammunition types. I have a lot of it, but I have yet to find a weapon for it, so if you are lucky enough to find it, that's good, but if not, don't worry. 0.50 caliber, that's a big bullet, no weapon for it yet. Grenade launcher, no weapon yet. The 10mm, well, I found a pistol. And I think there are some SMGs for it, but again, not really worth it, since I didn't find that much ammo, and the pistol doesn't do a lot of damage. 5x25, no, not really. Fusion shell, that's almost all the fusion cells I found in the whole game, including the kill robots. Mini nukes, no comment. Missiles, you can find a missile launcher, but that's level 20, and As you can see, they are pretty heavy. I don't recommend you using them. This is not so heavy. That ammo is not so heavy. Not so heavy. I also have some crossbow bolts, but no crossbow yet. So, just as a short recap, have a pipe rifle, a modified pipe rifle, the Snubnosed .44, the shotgun, pump and shotgun or double barrel, and the hunting rifle or the sniping rifle. With these weapons you'll almost never run out of ammo if you pick up the ammo pretty consistently. And you can also make a lot of ammo for them, because it's not so hard. Let me show you how much ammo you can make for these guns. So, let's go to ammo. Well, I can craft any ammo here, but you can craft ammo on the benches you find in the game. But it seems it's very hard to craft ammo at home. Well, this is my tactic for the game, and you can do pretty much, you can out DPS pretty much everything in the game if you have a pretty good armor. And again, each weapon you find after this level, around level 15, you can modify. And you should try to modify all the weapons you find. But at the same time, don't use a weapon that you don't have ammo for, because you don't have a lot of caps in this game. So either you make your own ammo, either you use weapons that have plentiful ammo. This has been my video for the Fallout 76 weapon so far. Something got cooked here. And remember to upgrade your base. And at the same time, when you level up, try to remember to put points in intelligence, because look at the gunsmith. Guns break 10% slower and you craft tier 1 guns. Also the scrapper. And also the armor. These are very important. So in this game, crafting is a lot more important, and so is leveling up. Well, that's the whole video. Until next time, bye bye.